Belarus is again at the very top of the international agenda for the events that everybody knows and the continued repression by Lukashenko's regime. This repression has been strongly condemned, as much as the massive human rights violations, which continue unabated since the past elections in August 2020. The recent events are related with the hijacking of a European Union airplane flying between two European Union capitals and forcing it to land in Minsk with intervention on air fighter, which is an act that oversteps many red lines. Not only it has jeopardized the security of over 100 passengers, it has also challenged international rules related with air transportations. The subsequent arrest of a young Belarusian journalist, as well as his partner, is an abhorrent act. Their forced confession in a state television is another example of the flagrant violations of basic human rights that Lukashenko's regime commit. We have to respond decisively against this image, against these facts. And already the day after the hijacking of the Ryan flight, the European Council met, put this issue in the agenda, and took decisions. The European Council called for additional sanctions, and for the first time, they decided to include targeted economic sanctions. Until now, our sanctions are usually taken on personal basis, affecting individuals and entities, but not the whole economy of a country. This time, the Council requested to take targeted economic sanctions. The Council also requested that all European Union-based carriers, air carriers, they have to avoid overflights of Belarus. Call also for adopting the necessary measures to ban overflights of the European Union airspace by Belarusian airlines and prevent access to European Union airports of flights operated by such airlines. And I can tell you that these measures have already been adopted last week. Listing of individuals and companies, including those involved in the Ryanair accident or incident, are well on track for adoption. And they will be adopted by written procedure in the following days. And as mandated by the European Council, and together with the Commission, we have starting targeted economic sanctions, as the Council requested. They will be adopted on the next Foreign Affairs Council, I hope, that the technical work will be finished and it will be affecting critical sectors of the Belarusian economy, but the final decision belongs to the member states. I hope they will be united on that. We have published a plan for a €3 billion economic investment package in support of democratic Belarus, sending a message of hope and support to the people of Belarus, showing the prospects for a more prosperous country once they come back to a democratic system.
Kiitokset, arvoisa korkea edustaja ja komissaari.